up? This is Nefis.
What's up? This is Jasmine, and we're live in New York City with the next supporting artist.
Yo, my boy,
Trey Song. Okay, so you know songs. That's your. I mean, it says everything in itself right there. Songs. So you know, you write your own music. We know that your first album was called Gotta Make It, and here he is, made it. Now he's on his second album, Trey Day.
This store is October 2nd, by the way.
That's good.
Yeah, it's so, going down. The album is, it's crazy. We got crazy production. Of course, Troy Taylor's on the project. My boy B Major, Jimmy Jam, Terry Lewis, Dre and Vidal, The Runners, R. Kelly, The Angel Hands, Stargate. And I could go on forever, you know what I mean?
How was it like working with R. Kelly?
It was great. He actually sent the record in that he wanted. He sent a couple records. He wrote them tailor-made for me, so I was very honored that he would take time. Because, you know, R. Kelly could give you a throwaway record anytime he wants to. So he wrote these records just for me, and I thought that was dope, man. Because coming up, like, I never imagined, you know what I mean? Like, a lot of people, when I first came out, sound like, trying to be R. Kelly, you know what I mean? And even with the little tiff we had, like, for him to come and want to be a part of my project, that was dope for me. Like, and the song we had was crazy.
I know you worked with, you said Stargate, right?
Yeah.
You got two joints on there?
Yeah.
With them? How was it like working with them?
Oh, Stargate did very professional, man. Like, we go in, we got it done. Like, actually, I did both of them songs in an hour and a half. Like, hour and a half, 2 hours.
The second single, Can't Help But Wait.
Can't Help But Wait. What's happening? My boy Jonte Austin was a big part of that record.
Make sure you request that at your local radio station.
Come on now, Fee, tell again.
That's what it is. Now, for those who don't know, you're a songwriter as well. So what's how many that? Songs did you write on this project?
I wrote all but two.
All but two?
All but two. Wrote on all but two. Even the R. Kelly record I wrote on, he sent it in, and he left a gap open. Troy and I, we wrote the bridge part together, so that was dope for me. Can't Help But Wait, like I said, Jonte Austin wrote that. And Jonte Austin, if you don't know, he's written Mary J. Blige, Be Without You, all of Mariah Carey's hit from last time around. So for him to be, and I've known him since I was younger in the game, since I first stepped into the game. I was 14 the first time I met Jonte. And for this record to be, for him to be a part of this record is important.
What's up, baby? We got this camera, right?
Yeah,
I got my album coming out October 2nd, so I need you to say Trey Day October 2nd. Make it a song.
Trey Day October 2nd.
Trey Day October 2nd.
And it's crazy though, because the first time I recorded an album, I didn't know what it was like to go out and perform those songs for people. Like, that's actually something that I've gained going into this second album. I have performance in mind when I make records now.
Okay.
Like, with the first album, I'm just making songs. I had guidance from my mentor, the producer Troy Taylor, as well as other producers, but now I know what my fans like at my shows. I know what to do in certain songs. I know what makes them go crazy.
Those
I know what, yeah, exactly.
Throw things at you.
Exactly. So I think the difference is you're making the song and you bring the song to life when you're on stage.
What is your favorite song on your second album that you would love to perform that you probably just know is gonna rock the crowd?
Favorite song? I don't know if it's, I wouldn't say it's my favorite song, but it's a song called Long Gone Missing that I haven't performed yet.
Okay.
It's the song that opens the album up. It's real amp. It's B Major produced that record, and I can't wait to perform that.
Okay.
What's gonna make this album different from the last album?
Well, it's different because 2 years later, I'm older. I've, like, it's kind of like the evolution of man. You're seeing you growing up before your eyes, you know what I mean? The first album, Just Gotta Make It, Petersburg, Virginia, we shot the video, you saw me, like, in my essence, like, waking up out of the bed, like, it's all me. It was very raw, and I feel like you watched me turn into, I don't really consider myself a star, but I am a celebrity, I am famous. When I go places, I do take pictures and sign autographs, so you watched me go from that kid to who I am now, and I think that I know what my fans want to hear, and my voice has grown a lot. I sing all the time, so, like, naturally, my voice has grown, and I'm hard on myself, so all the songs on the album are just as the first album was. We got great content, we got great subject matter, and the songs have substance, you know what I mean? They're not some songs you're going to listen to today and not going
to
like them.
I have to ask a question for the ladies now. Since you have a lot of R&B, your songs are romantic, and you have a new song called Wonder Woman. So I have to ask you, what is your Wonder Woman like?
Wonder Woman.
Do you have a Wonder Woman in your life?
Wonder Woman is...
Do you have one in your life right now?
How you gonna ask two?
Can I ask that one first? Do you have one?
I have a woman in my life.
Okay.
Yeah, she hold me down.
Say that to the camera so they know.
They heard. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's definitely but it's hard out here, like, and to be in a relationship. So we young and we understand that, because she's in the business as well, and like moving city to city and working as much as I do. Like, I've been here for 4 hours. I woke up 5 o'clock this morning. I don't have time to check in with nobody and do this, that, and the other. So she's very understanding, and I love her, and she hold me down.
So part of the qualities is understanding.
Yeah, understand. You got to be sexy. You got to be sexy. Don't trip. I'm from the South, so I like a little bottle. Just to be honest, baby. But I like women in all shapes and sizes, though. I think women are the most beautiful things on earth. Like, we wouldn't have nothing. Where Earth would be nothing without women.
So on your album, do you have any songs that were written about her, or maybe about exes from the past, bad relationships maybe that went wrong and you just had to write about it?
No. I mean, I write about certain situations, like, and I reference this song because a lot of fellas can relate to it. It's a song called Store Run. Big up the Clutch and Dre and Vidal. When fellas, you get into a situation where you might go see a lady, you might not have known that it was gonna go as far as it went, so you ain't got your props with you, you know what I mean? You gotta make a run to the store, and the whole suspense and the thing is, in the time you go into the store to get your props, you gotta make sure she's still in the mood. When you get back, you might get back with your prophylactics and she not ready, like it's over. So that's a song that's I think all fellas go through. I have experienced that myself.
You said that you's a liar. Grip them legs back, homie, pliers. Cheap full chrome up under the tires. And you so grown in my desires to make you finish that room. Hey, who said Trey Songz ain't fire?
The way you talk and girl, it seems so impotent. It's more than sexy, girl. The way that you take control. I want the woman. Are you my kind of woman? You act like that, you fly like jets. Are you my one woman? It's a shame the way you do
this. October 2nd.
That's right.
Trey Day, October 2nd. I'm most definitely looking into movies, all that. Like, also want to make sure when I do step into acting or whatever I may do, I want to make sure I treat it with as much love and respect as I did music. All
right. This is good advice right here for people who are trying to make it. Like, it is. What do you say to youngsters that are trying to come up too? Like,
I mean, I tell them stay on their grind. I mean, God played a heavy part in me being where I am right now. Like, I prayed to the Lord and asked him if this was what I was supposed to do. And along with that, like, I never gave up. I believe in myself no matter what anyone says. I take constructive criticism. And for you out there, like, y'all just stay on your grind. If you believe in yourself, ain't nothing stopping you. Can't nothing stop you. This is what you're meant to do. And don't sit there and pout, and, you know what I mean? Make excuses for yourself, and somebody can shut you down, like you shut yourself down, like, use that as fuel. Hey, this your boy Trey Songz, baby, you know what it is. You reading and watching VelvetAddiction.com. Trey Day.
You're so fly. So fly.